In this video, we will create this part here, and you will learn how to use the extrude, extrude intersect, chamfer, and fillet. So open your Fusion and let's go. The first step to create this part here, we will select the front plane and make this sketch, okay? Let's make a zoom here, and this sketch. We have all dimensions here. Here is our midpoint, okay? So the first thing that we'll make these two circles here. One with 50 millimeters of diameter and another one with 28 millimeters of diameter. And the distance between the center of the circle and the midpoint is 80 millimeters and 108 millimeters, okay? So open the Fusion. Go to create a sketch and select the front plane, select the circle. Let me show the snap grid here, okay? A circle with 50 millimeters and another circle with 28 millimeters, okay? Go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 108 millimeters. And the distance here is 8 millimeters. We made this, okay? Now we'll make this circle here on this side, a circle with 50 millimeters of diameter and a circle with 28 millimeters of diameter. And the distance between the center of these two circles and the midpoint is 120 millimeters and 110 millimeters. So select circle. Make a circle here with 50 millimeters of diameter and another one with 28 millimeters. Okay, go to sketch dimension. The distance here, 120 millimeters. And the distance here is 110 millimeters. Okay, we made this. Let me move this a little bit here. Okay. Now let's create this construction line here at the midpoint, okay? So select line, select the construction line, click here in the midpoint, make a construction line here. It is for reference. Now let's create this arc here. This arc has 225 millimeters of radius, and we know that the center of this arc is constrained with the midpoint, horizontal vertical constraints, okay? And this arc is tangent with this circle. So go to Fusion, go to create, select arc, three-point arc, click here in the circle and click here in this line. Remove the construction line type, okay? Okay. Now go to Constraint, select Horizontal Vertical, select the center of this arc, and select the midpoint here, okay? And go to Constraint again, select Tangent, select this arc and this circle here. And go to Sketch Dimension. The radius here is 225 millimeters. Okay, we made this. Now let's create this arc here. This arc, we don't have the dimensions, but we know that this arc here is tangent with this one and tangent with the circle. So select the arc, three-point arc, click here on this point and this circle here. Make this arc tangent with this arc and tangent with the circle. Okay, we made this. Now let's create this arc here. We know that this arc is tangent with the circle and tangent with this arc here. And we know that this point here is constrained with this one. And the distance between this point here and the midpoint is 150 millimeters. So go to create, select arc, 3-point arc, click here in the circle, make an arc here, okay, tangent with the circle, okay, and go to sketch dimension. The radius here is 150 millimeters. Okay. Now go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point here, this point, okay, and go to sketch dimension. The distance between this point here and this point here is 150 millimeters. Okay, we made this. Now let's create this arc here. We don't have the dimension of this arc, but we know that it is tangent with this arc here, okay? And tangent with this circle. So go to create, 3-point arc, click here on this arc and click here. It is tangent with this circle. Now let me make this tangent with this arc. And we made this, okay? We have this. Now, we need to create this line here, okay? This arc here inside. To make this, we use the features offset. But first, we'll go to modify and select break. And break this circle here. And break this circle here, okay? Now, let's see the dimension here. The distance between these two lines here, the offset is 11 millimeters, okay? 11 millimeters here. Look at this, 11 millimeters. And all this side, 11 millimeters. So, go to modify, select offset. Select this line here. This, we need it to break because we need only this part of the circle, okay? If you don't break this, we'll won't make the offset. You can't make this offset. Okay? 11 millimeters. Press OK. Okay, we have this. Let me move the dimensions a little bit. Okay. Now, we need to make this fillet. We have a fillet here in the four edges here. This fillet is 90 millimeters of radius. So go to modify, select fillet. Select here this point, 90 millimeters. This point here. This point here and this point here. Press OK. The design lost the reference, but no problem. You go to sketch dimension, select this arc here and this 11 millimeters, okay. Select this two 11 millimeters. Select here 11 millimeters. This point in the circle. This arc and the circle here 11 millimeters. Okay. We finish the sketch one. Now go to finish the sketch. We made this. Now we needed to extrude this, okay? We made all this sketch. We needed to extrude this 108 millimeters, okay? The distance between this point here and this point here, 108 millimeters. So go to extrude, select this profile here. The direction here is symmetric. Measurement whole length, and the distance here 180 millimeters, okay? Operation new body, press OK. We made this. Now, go to create a sketch and select the top plane. The first thing that we'll make here, go to create, select the project include, project. The selection filter here, select the bodies. Select this body here and press OK. We can hide this body one. We have this, okay? And the first thing that we'll make a line here with 230 millimeters, okay. So let's make this. Select the line, click here at the midi point of the line here. 230 millimeters. Press OK. We have this. Now we'll make a line here with 20 millimeters and select the line, click here, 20 millimeters. Now here, we'll select this point here, make a line with 20 millimeters and make two arcs here and make another line here to meet this point, okay? So select the line. Here we have two points here, so make sure to take this one. 120 millimeters. Okay, now make an arc here and another arc and make a line here. Okay, let's make this line a vertical line, okay? Go to constraint, select tangent, make this arc tangent with this line here, tangent with this arc, and this arc must be tangent with this line. Now go to constraints, select equal, make these two arc equal, okay? The radius here is 8 millimeters. So go to dimension, the radius here, 8 millimeters, press OK. We made this. Now, let's create this line here with 30 millimeters and create a line here and here, okay? So select the line, click here on this point, make a line here with 30 millimeters. Okay, make a line here. Okay, we made this. Now here, make a fillet here at this point. The fillet here has 50 millimeters of radius. So the radius here is 50 millimeters. Press OK. We made this, okay? Let me hide the projected geometries here. So here we go to create and select mirror. Select these lines here. You make the same in this side here, okay? The mirror line is this line here and press OK. We made this, okay? Now finish the sketch. Show the body one here. And now we need to go to extrude. Select this profile, okay, the both sides. The direction here is symmetric. The extended type, select all. And the operation here, select intersect. We made this, okay? Press OK. Now to finish this, we need to create the chamfer and the fillets. In the holes, we have a chamfer with 2 millimeters in the both sides, okay? So let's make this chamfer here. Go to modify, select chamfer, select this edge here, this one. Rotate this, select this edge here. The chamfer here is 2 millimeters, press OK. We made this, okay? Now we need to create the fillets. So the fillet is 5 millimeters. So select this face here, okay? And in the other side of this face. So go to fillet, select this face here, 5 millimeters. Okay. Now add selection set, select the inside face here, 5 millimeters. And press OK. We made this, okay? So here we finish our exercise. So thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel for more and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.